So we're back in the kitchen with Jason. We've got another recipe to do. This time we're going to use verjus.
I'm going to talk about that in a second. I want to get to the beets on because I think the big thing is beets, baby beets. Look at them. They're fantastic. What do we do with them? I don't know. Okay. So the thing is, vegetables, they come in season. We get all excited about them. We cook with them. And then they go bye-bye and we don't have them in the winter. And it's a shame.
Right.
Whereas we can pickle them. We can have them extend through the seasons.
We're going to pickle our beets.
Yeah. So what I'm doing is just nice little baby beets. You can do the larger beets if you like. You can do different types of beets. But just cut the tops off. Okay, like that. Put them in a pot. But I want to show you,
though. Those are some gnarly-looking beets, though, eh?
Pretty cool. I like
them. Yeah, I like them.
Yeah, got a little antennas going on.
Yeah.
But this part is just as good. Remember, it's like a Swiss chard. If you wash this really well, chop it up, stir fry it, fantastic. So don't throw them.
So good for you. Oh. I mean, you know the dark leafy greens are always really, really good, full of nutrients and vitamins.
Beets. Healthy, fresh, coming out of my mouth. Can you believe it? No bacon in here? Okay, I couldn't even figure out how to. I tried. There was no way I'd get bacon in this. But anyway, in a pot, cold water poured over top, a little bit of salt, and then bring them up to cook. Here's the thing that frustrates me with beets.
Okay.
People put them in a pot, they put them on, they go watch the hockey game, they go watch whatever, they come back 6 hours later, and they've got this beet that's cooked, they strain all that liquid down the drain, and what happened is all the flavor went down the drain.
Okay?
So you want to cook them just till they're almost done.
Okay.
And I've got some here, you can see, I got some nice little yellow beets.
They
here.
Smell amazing.
Don't they?
I wish you guys could smell, they smell amazing.
But you can see, it just slides in, slides out, and what I did was as soon as they were like about 85% cooked, then I took them off. And I need my little rubber gloves here, and just let them cool down in the liquid.
Okay.
Okay, and the reason I did that is because all the flavor that was in the liquid has now gone back into the beet.
Now you're using the gloves because these guys will really stay in your hands,
yes.
right?
Yes, well the yellow ones aren't so bad, but look how easy this is. See this, you just rub it, it peels off.
Oh, good stuff.
Isn't that great?
Uh-huh.
And it's a great job because when the kids are bugging, you just say, go peel the beets, you know? And they sit there and they peel the beets for the night. But no, it just peels off like that, right? Same with the red ones. Here's where you want to do, you know.
These ones will really stain.
You make the beets and you also do the tie-dye shirts. Now I feel old, but that's okay.
Time.
But look, that's what I love is they come off so easy and you end up with the beets like that.
Very cool. So this is what we want in the very end.
Yeah.
This is then.
Yeah. And they're good to go for dinner tonight.
Is there a big difference in flavor between the red and the yellow?
A little bit more delicate, these are more earthiness, these are a little sweeter, you know, different textures like that, which is great. But they're good to go for dinner, but how do we extend it for the season? Well, what we do is we just chop them up, put them into little jars like we did with our jam, and then we make our pickle, okay?
We're going to pickle them.
Yeah. So what I've got is...
some sugar. We couldn't fit the bacon and cream in, but we did find a way to put
but you needed
gobs
to preserve
of sugar.
It, right?
That's
then
okay.
I have a sherry vinegar. Right? Nice little flavor in there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then the verjus.
So now we're using the verjus.
Yes. And I've got about 3 cups of verjus. And the reason for that is verjus isn't as strong as the sherry vinegar.
Okay.
What verjus is unripened grape juice.
Right.
So when the grapes are growing, they end up with 10, 15 bunches on the vines. Well, at a certain time of year, they want to thin that back to only 10 bunches. And the reason for that is because all the nutrients in the vine will only go to 10 rather than 15.
Mm-hmm.
Those bunches will be fuller, more flavorful. So the ones they pull off are little grapes that aren't ripened. They're really acidic, really tart, so they crush them down and make verjus.
Very good.
Unripened grape juice.
Yeah, very good. I know we explained that on a Three Chef show, but it's so good because you use that in multiple different ways,
I'm telling you, this is starting to come on the market all over the place. You can look around for it, and it is a nice, light, for making salad dressings, for putting over fish. It's just fresh. Anyway, I'm getting off track here, but... So, beets, then what I do, I'm going to add a little bit of flavor. So I throw a little vanilla in there.
Nice.
A little bit of vanilla, you know. A little tarragon in there. But, you know, whatever you like. If you want to throw a few pink peppercorns in there. It's whatever flavors you think are fun. You were saying earlier, how do you know?
Mm.
Well, you put it in there and you try it. If it doesn't
taste
good, don't do it next time, you know. But that's the fun of cooking, right? And then you, let's just see if I can do this, but... pour. Oh, I'm going to do it. Go for it.
So this is the mixture that you just boiled down, right?
Yeah. So it's a sherry, vinegar, verjus, and sugar. And I'm good at making a mess, as you can see.
But good stuff.
Pour
better
like
than
that.
I would have.
Boiling hot in there, because we're using the concept now of, I'm going to put the lid on. Now, I didn't talk about this with the jam, but I guess it does apply as well, and I should have, is if you're a little afraid of the whole boiling process, you can literally just put the lids on now.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's hot... as they cool down, the lids will pop down. They will seal, sort of. There's still the air in there, but that means they can last up to 6 to 8 weeks.
Okay.
But if you put them in the jar and you boil them up and you remove all that steam and you get it down, then you
last them for
stick
a long
them on the shelf
time.
Till, you know, when you can serve them at your grandkids' wedding or something. I don't know.
Wow.
But,
okay. They last a long time, in other words. Very good.
Pickled beets.
That's how you keep your beets, everyone. Well,